So now we are going to see what is in Bitcoin. So before going to that, you will see what is physical currency. So the physical currency, we have seen Indian rupee, US dollar, and euro pound like that. In those cases, we can touch and feel the currency. Whereas, for example, this is Indian 10 rupees note. We can touch that currency and we can feel the value of this currency. So if you go and buy, if this paper has the value to buy some stuff. So that's the power of this physical currency. Whereas in Bitcoin is not a physical currency, it's a virtual currency. So you can't touch, but you can sense the value of that Bitcoin. And one more difference is the physical currency, that is Indian rupee, US dollar, euro, pound, is managed by some authority. In case of Indian rupee, it's managed by central government. So if suppose if there is any inflation rate, the Reserve Bank has the authority to inflow the money by printing more currencies. So that's a major difference between Bitcoin and the normal currency. So whereas in Bitcoin, there is no any central authority for maintaining this. There is a certain amount that in the world we can mine only a particular amount of Bitcoins. You can't mine more than that. So we'll talk more about that in the upcoming videos. So I will summarize the points. Bitcoin is a virtual currency. You can't touch it, but you can feel the value of that money. And then it's not controlled by an authority or a government. It is decentralized. So in the upcoming videos, we will talk more about the Bitcoin in detailed way. So at the end of the video, you would see a channel icon here. Please click on that for subscribing the channel. Thanks for watching.